There used to be a song in our language in the past 20 years which say that the best job is agriculture and the rest is chance. Today I would say that the best is information technology. We are moving our economy from an agrarian-based economy to a knowledge-based economy, and the young people are the forefront of that transformation. So the tools that you need today to do a productive work is IT. So I think at the intersection of IT and youth is about innovation, it's about jobs, and it's about transformation of an economy. Rwanda is hosting a summit, a Transform Africa Summit, from the 28th October to the 1st of November. Part of that event is a youth innovation exhibition or extravaganza. We want to bring the youth as part of a global discussion. Connecting to transform is what we see as the post 2015 agenda. And we want the voice of the youth to be part of it. And not just speak or talk about it, but show innovations on how IT can actually transform lives. Rwanda has selected 5 key sectors for our next 5-year development plan called EDPRS2, where we want really to use ICT to drive transformation. And those sectors are agriculture, education, healthcare, financial services and financial inclusion, and government service delivery. So in those sectors, we see education becoming a 21st century education. We see IT making the world increasingly flat in terms of accessing quality content that the students in a remote village in Rwanda can have the same education that a kid in New York. So that's how we see the transformation happening. We want preventive healthcare to get to the people, but also clinical support, you know, medication reminders and so on. So ICT in Rwanda has already started saving lives. It's not a story that we tell of what ICT can do, is what ICT has already achieved. For us, universal access will be achieved if the market works at the bottom of the pyramid. Previously, people thought that governments could, you know, keep subsidizing access, giving people free access to ICTs. But we believe that if we can figure out a way that creates a win-win between the suppliers and the supply and the demand of IT services, then universal access can happen. And the role of government, in my view, is to put up in place the right regulatory framework and policies, and then maybe stimulate the market at the demand side, no longer at the supply side, as it used to be the case for many governments. One thing that we realized is that for developing a knowledge economy, leadership is important. So we have learned a lot from the work that ITU is doing. Our president, His Excellency Paul Kagame, is the co-chair of the Broadband Commission. So Rwanda staying in that leadership position is very important. It helps us being part of a global discussion which shapes the future, but also helps others. So we come there and learn from what others have done, and we hope that our own experience in our small way can also inspire others. Taking part in IU Telecom events has allowed Rwanda to really be at the forefront of the changes, technological changes that are shaping our world. We hope that Rwanda will be the first one to finish with a digital migration, for instance, which we're not first to start, but for us, after learning from what others have done, we are able to move faster and be the first to complete the migration. So that's just one example. But we are also looking at other opportunities for relationships with the public sector, private sector, opinion leaders, so that we can move ahead together.